Hello everybody, I'm Dr. Jitendra Pandey, and today in this lecture we are going to discuss about online banking security. Most industries have deployed internet technologies as an essential part of their business operations. The banking industry is one of the industries that has adopted internet technologies for their business operations, and in their plans, policies and strategies to be more accessible, convenient, competitive, and economical as an industry. The aim of these strategies was to provide online banking customers the facilities to access and manage their banking accounts easily and globally. Online banking, also known as internet banking, e-banking, or virtual banking, is an electronic payment system that enables customers of a bank or other financial institution to conduct a range of financial transactions through the financial institution's website. The online banking system will typically connect to or be a part of the core banking system operated by a bank and is in contrast to branch banking, which was the traditional way customers accessed banking services. Online banking has been deployed more frequently over the past few decades to support and improve the operational and managerial performance within the banking industry. Threats to online banking. There are some information security threats and risks associated with the use of online banking systems. The confidentiality, privacy, and security of internet banking transactions and personal information are the major concerns for both the banking industry and internet banking. Attacks on online banking today are based on deceiving the user to steal login data. Phishing, farming, cross-site scripting, adware, keyloggers, malware, spyware, trojans, and viruses are currently the most common online banking security threats and risks. The following are the major attack scenarios. Number one is a credential stealing attack, is where fraudsters try to gather users' credential either with the use of malicious software or through phishing. Number two is a channel breaking attack. It involves intercepting the communication between the client side and the banking server by masquerading as the server to the client and vice versa. And the third attack scenario is content manipulation, also called man-in-the-browser attack, which takes place in the application layer between the user and the browser. The adversary is granted with privileges to read, write, change, and delete browser's data whilst the user is unaware about it. Now we will discuss the best practices for online banking users. The first thing that you need to do is protect your PC. So the next logical question is how? Following are some of the tips for protecting your personal computer. Install antivirus software and keep it updated on a regular basis to guard against new viruses. Install anti-spyware security software against those programs that monitor, record, and extract the personal information you type in your PC, like passwords, card numbers, ID numbers, etc. Install personal firewalls to protect your PC against unauthorized access by hackers. Keep your operating system and internet browser up to date, checking for and downloading new versions or security enhancement from the vendor's website. The second important concern is protect your personal information. This can be achieved by following these steps. Create hard-to-guess security access codes like user IDs and passwords for online banking and make them unique. They should not be the same as those you use to access your email account. Change your security access codes periodically. Memorize your security access codes, avoid writing them down, and keep them strictly personal and confidential. Do not disclose to anyone your security access code. Bank will never initiate or contact you for your e-banking or ATM pins, card or account numbers, personal identification information, neither over the phone nor in any electronic or written message. Also refrain from providing ATM pin for e-commerce transactions. Never leave your PC unattended when logged into online banking. Always remember to log off from your online session using the log off button when finished using the e-banking services. The third important concern is use the internet cautiously. And this can be done by following these suggestions. Always access online banking internet only by typing the URL in the address bar of your browser. Never attempt to access online banking internet through an external link of unknown or suspicious origin appearing on other websites, search engines, or emails. Before logging in, check for the bank's security certificate details and the various signs like green address line and lock, HTTPS, etc. that confirm you are visiting the secure pages of bank. Ignore and delete immediately suspicious fraudulent emails that appears to be from bank, asking you to urgently click a link to a fraudulent website that tries to mimic the bank's site and to lure you into giving out your sensitive personal information like PIN, account or card numbers, personal identification information, etc. Never click on a link contained in suspicious emails. Avoid using online banking from public shared PCs such as internet cafes, libraries, etc. to avoid the risk of having your sensitive private information copied and abused. The fourth important tip to avoid fraud while using online banking is stay alert. Sign on to online banking regularly and review your account transactions, checking for any fraudulent activity on your account, like transactions you do not recognize. Keep track of your last logon date and time displayed at the top left side of the online banking homepage. Once logged into online banking, you can also monitor the actions performed online. Last but not the least is prompt reporting of suspicious activity. Contact your bank immediately if you think someone knows your security access code, or in case of theft of your code or money, or in case you have forgotten your credentials. Forward any suspicious emails to the bank on their phishing reporting email as well as on cert email ID shown in the screen. Your prompt action is crucial to prevent any further damage. After going through this lecture, I hope you will be able to use your online banking confidently now. Thank you very much.